I'm really excited to be doing this video on the Standing Liberty Silver Quarters, what you guys should be looking for on your Standing Liberty Quarters that can give them value. And don't forget, I gave away a bunch of silver coins last week. We're going to start doing silver coin giveaways every single Sunday on the live stream. So if you guys don't want to miss out on those free silver coin giveaways, all you have to do is just press the bell on my channel and it will notify you guys when I am live streaming. That way you guys can hop right into the chat and enter the giveaways. All right, so let's start off here first with the 1928 Standing Liberty Silver Quarter. Of course, 90% silver. Now, this is the 1928D. Now, if you're not familiar with where the mint mark is gonna be, it's gonna be right here next to the star, kind of to the left of the date there at the bottom of the coin. So this coin here is only graded at an extra fine 40. So, you know, it's not in the worst condition, but definitely not in the best. The coin only sold for around $45. Now, if we compare that to something like this coin here, a 1928D, now this coin is graded at a mint state 67 and it's got a full head, which I'll show you an example of here in 1 second. Now, this coin sold for over $70,000. Could you imagine selling one coin for $70,000? That's what this coin sold for. It's authenticated by NGC, graded by them, graded at that high grade, that mint state 67 grade. That's gonna be super, super important when valuing these types of coins. Now here's an example here on the right of the full head. Here's an example on the left of the non-full head. So if you guys wanna, you know, screenshot this and use that for an example to look at your coins, feel free to do so. But back to the 1928s. So on the D mint mark, you can also look for a repunched mint mark. So here's a couple examples of that repunched mint mark on your 1928D Standing Liberty Quarters. Now, this is the 1928 no mint mark. The coin has been cleaned. Definitely do not clean your coins because it will devalue them. And it is graded at an extra fine 40. This coin sold for around $25 as compared to a 1928 high graded version of this coin, graded at a mint state 67 with the full head. This coin sold for over $12,000. So huge, huge difference in coin prices there based on the condition of the coin or the grade of the coin. Now real quick, just to show you how many they made in 1928, the no mint mark, 6.3 million, the D mint mark, 1.6 million, and the S mint mark, only 2.6 million. So the D mint mark is the lowest mintage of the three for the year 1928. So we have a couple different mint marks. We have a large S here and a large S here, different types of mint marks. Now we also have the small S. So here's an example of that. And then we also have the repunched mint mark on the S mint mark. So not just the D mint mark, but also a repunched mint mark on the S mint mark, which we see here in the images displayed. Now for the S mint mark, repunched mint mark, here is a coin that is graded at a very fine 30. It's got that repunched mint mark. And this coin sold for around $100. So, you know, in this condition, not too bad. You know, it's not in really great condition at all. Now, if you compare that to the same coin, however, this coin has a high grade. It's got the large S, the RPM. It's got the high grade of a mint state 65. We go from a $100 coin to a $1,300 coin. So $1,300 for that coin. We also have an inverted mint mark here. Now this is the S mint mark and it's only graded at a 4. So super, super low on the coin grading scale. You can see how worn down the coin is. This quarter here sold for over $75. So really good price for that condition. Now for the 1928 S, this coin does not have any types of errors. It's just solely valuable because of its high grade of the mint state 67 with the full head. This coin sold for over $9,000. 9,000 buggeroos. So don't forget to go check out my other silver coin videos where I show you some more coin prices. Alright guys, don't forget to subscribe in the middle. Check out the videos to the left of me. And until tomorrow, I will see you on the comment section below. This is Couch Collectibles and this is where I disappear.